Okay, this class is on this Hadoop. So how do we create a cloud in Hadoop, and also how do we run a Hadoop program? And our end objective is to do a simple calculating of this word count. So this is the word count, so we want to calculate that I, there's 2, M, there's 2, going, there's 2, school and toilet, only 1. So this is our purpose. So our maple, so that means to map the data that we want. So this is our maple, so we want to bring in the word. So the reducer will be the one who is calculating the computation. So the calculating of this of the word count. So this is a word count. So this one will be run in Hadoop platform. So the first thing is we need to set up the Hadoop, and the first thing is we need to go to Google Cloud Platform. So if you go to Google Cloud Platform, so just click this Google Cloud Services, and you'll be inside here. First, you have to, register yourself, and there'll be free credit for you. So of course you can just type Google, or you can actually go to this link as well, okay, Google Cloud Platform. And then after that, the first thing is you search for this data block. So what you do is that this one, you search this Google Cloud Platform. So you'll be here, so called data block. So this is the one data block, and so you have to go and create one based on this data block. So this is a VM. So remember, there's a cluster name and the zone. You can pick Asia, Southeast Asia, Southeast. So it's called Southeast Asia. Then after that, you just select single node, one master and zero local. And then after that, this is the cluster that you create. So it's called cluster 3093. So this is the one, cluster 3093. So this is the cluster that we want to, we have a data prop there. And this is the cluster that we have Hadoop, okay. So this is the, now we are in this cluster, okay. So, but we haven't start the VM instance yet. So after that, we need to start the VM instance. So we are now in cluster. So the next thing is to start the VM instance. So how to start the VM instance? Just click here. So there's this cluster here. So you have to start the cluster. So with this, we are actually starting and is running. Okay. So now, so this is the place where it starts charging. So remember to off it when you're not using it. So the charging started now, okay? So remember to press off once you finished, okay? So this is the secure shell. So now you're in the VM instance. So this is the instance that you have. And so we are here, so VM instance, and so remember to off it, okay? If not, you will charge into your credit card, okay? Start the shell. So here I explain what is SSH. It is basically encrypted, so whatever you type in is secured, okay? So in the event that this is important to you, so of course the first thing is we want to look at the Hadoop fs-ls. So there shouldn't be anything as initially, even ls there shouldn't be anything, right? For the very start. So for the very start, Okay, so you are now in the secure shell, so LS, so you shouldn't have, okay, by right, you shouldn't have anything. I've loaded the word count and this I created reducer.py and maple.py. So actually, you can just upload. I'm going to show you. So I'm going to remove the word count first to make it nothing. So txt. Okay, so there's nothing now. There's nothing, nothing in the word count. So I just want to show you how to upload. So from this button, you click and you can upload. So this is the word count that we wanted to upload. Okay, so this, okay, that's quite fast. So LS, okay. So, but now we have to look at the Hadoop more important because now we're in Hadoop. So we have simple LS, RM. So here is some of the command that you can use. That is in the simple command in the shell, in the SSH. So it's a Linux shell, Linux. So these are all the Linux command in our shell. Okay. Then after that, Hadoop command. So the simplest one is HD. FS file system and then DFS and hyphen ls. So this is the most basic one. So to look at the directory, of course you can remove and then put, okay, for example. So later I'm going to show you this Hadoop first. Let's check the directory, see if we have anything inside Hadoop. Okay, so now we have two things, so I just will remove both of them, so the data and the data output. Okay, so shouldn't have any in the first place, there shouldn't be any data here. So in the Hadoop file system, so I'm going to put after we load this data, the word count, so we need to put into Hadoop file system. Okay, so in order to put into Hadoop file system, so I'm going to make a directory called data. Okay, make a directory called data. So now in the Hadoop system, So now if I look at Hadoop fs minus Hadoop dfs minus ls, so I should see this data as a directory, correct? But there's nothing inside the data yet. But the data is inside the inside the word count, so it's inside the Linux, not inside the Hadoop, So we need to put the word count inside the Hadoop. So how to do it? Very simple. I'm just going to put the word count into the data so that in the Hadoop I can find it. So I'm going to leave it here and just put it here. Only just put the word count into the data. So if I Hadoop now to the screen, so now, okay, if I'm looking at the Hadoop, this ls, so there should be a data there, right? So if I just go to Hadoop ls data, then I should be able to see the word count there. It's inside the word count. So now this word count is inside Hadoop now. Okay. So the next thing is that we have to create the two file, which is the maple and reducer. Okay. So in order to do that, what we do is that I need to this vim maple and reducer. So what you need to do is actually you need to do the maple. For example, you just open with this any editor. And here you just copy the whole thing and then paste it there. Paste it in the vim. So if you look at ls, so what you do is the vim maple.txt.py. Okay. So it's the editor. So you just paste it in, since I paste it here already, right? So in order to paste it, you press I, okay, in the insert mode here. Then you can start to type anything you like. So once you finished, you can just escape, then WQ, then you're out. So then after that, Vim is here. Maple.py is here. Okay. So the same thing for reducer. So you should Vim reducer. Reducer, okay. Then in this same thing, you should just use the reducer. Just use the reducer, then edit with any editor. Then just copy the whole thing, okay. Control C, then you paste it in. So in order to paste it here, remember use I to go to insert mode. Then you can paste it, okay. So after that, to save it, you press escape colon. WQ, right and quit, then you're done. Then you should have two files here. Okay, so the vim command is actually basically two is needed, I to insert, but remember to escape if you are in other mode, and remember WQ, right and quit. This is to save and exit. Okay, but remember escape first. Okay, so same thing, you always must escape first. Okay. So there are only two commands here. So one is I, but of course you can do other things as well. Huh? So whichever mode you are in, remember to escape first. Else here. So now you have your maple and reducer there. Okay. Then the first thing you need to do is you try the Python, see whether it works or not. Okay. So this is a step. To make sure that it works before we go to Hadoop. Okay, so Control C, this is to install the Python 3. So Control C, so mine is already done, so installed. Okay, so anyway, you just need to install it. Then you need to give the mode, the maple and reducer, the rights to read something and write something. So now you change the mode for these two to give them more rights, maple and reducer. So now you just change mode, okay, maple, then of course you can do same for reducer. So before we go to Hadoop, so let's try out first. You know, full quicks labs, full bar cocks, whatever. Okay, so just try. So this is to try whether maple and reducer work. Okay, before we go to Hadoop. Okay, Control V. Okay, so let's try. So you can see bar, there's one, full, there are three, right? Labs, there's one, and then quicks, there's two. Okay, so it proves that this maple and reducer work, right? So now we go to Hadoop. Okay. So now, in case you have anything in the data output which we don't have, because I deleted just now. So now I run this Hadoop. Okay. So I put the output in data underscore output slash star inside here. So let's run the Hadoop first. Okay. So now it's running the Hadoop. It may take a while for the Hadoop. Let me stop the recording first. Okay, it's done now. So, but our data will be in this our latest one. Let me show you the Hadoop first. Hadoop. So we always go to LX. So the output will be inside here. Let me clear the screen first. So the data will be inside here. Okay. So the data will be inside here, data output. So now in order to take a look at the data output, we should do this command called cat. Cat means type it up on the screen. So to cat it there, then what we do is that, now go to this, okay, cat it there, V. Okay, so this is the one. Okay, so the last thing we wanted to do is this KLS, and the data is in this data output here. So for this command, please do not cut and paste. So please type it out. So HDFS to HDFS DFS minus cat. So our data is in the data underscore output and slash start. Okay, so this one please type it out. So you get the answer. I'm going to school. Only school and toilet is one each. And that's all for the demo for Hadoop. And thank you for listening. And again, remember to stop the VM after you use it. Okay. And of course, you can always look at the billing, which is not really critical. It's the free trial credit to make sure you don't exit. Later, you will receive a bill of few hundred dollars in your credit card. So please be very careful. So once you finish, please remember to this stop here. This is important, not the stop. Okay. So stop the instance. Thank you for listening.